hubby is my photographer, but over here in Dubai is the complete opposite of what she said. Dubai is hot, summer is coming up. I will endure all that heat, eh? Carry myself, me, go under that sun, punish my husband to take me pictures, Instagram posts, right there, right, left, center. A brand comes to me when I've made it to, when I've made it big. A brand comes to me, Dolly, we would give you free clothes in exchange for 5 Instagram posts. No. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, you're very much welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, viewer, thank you guys. Today I'm going to be, you know, reacting to another YouTuber's video. I never do this. I just think, you know, when people take the time to, you know, create unique content, you know, interesting content, give them all the benefits that video deserves. But I recently watched this YouTuber's video. She's called Brinny Lee, a UK-based black YouTuber. That girl kept dropping fire from the beginning of the video till the end, like fire after fire. I was like, this thing, I can feel it in my soul. I've got to react and say something about it. Yes, if you've never known, especially when you're influencers could maybe be bloggers, YouTubers, when they start off, most of them are broke, especially if you're not from a wealthy background, you know, where you can support the lifestyle, all those bum pictures, vacations, and you know, that goals, Insta lifestyle. Most of them start off broke. Brinny Lee filmed this video where she was like, the title of her video was like, why most influencers are broke. I watched that video, perfect. Check out her channel, subscribe to her channel, because that video was straight up fire. Well, reacting to that video, she said a lot of things. One of the first things she said was, in the first place, this is my opinion, why would I even hang my hat where I cannot reach? Why would I come and kill myself with spending my 9 to 5 income, spending all my income on clothes, shoes, everything to impress you or my Instagram followers when I don't have food on my table? I beg. This girl has to hang her hat where she can reach. That's the first thing I would say. She said a lot of things, but part of what really caught my attention when she was this. A lot of influencers you see, they take selfie after selfie on Instagram. All kinds of poses of selfies. No, you've got to diversify your feed. I caught that. I was like, yes, sis, preaching. Why would you take selfie after selfie? Selfie, so what? Diversify your feed. Put other things. It could be clothes and stuff like that. And when you're going to spend your coins to buy clothes, shoes, and all of that, tag those brands. How would ASOS know you've won an outfit from them? How would Zara know? How would Reebok know? How would Nike know? How would Adidas know that you went shopping from them? Tag those brands on Instagram. Stop taking cute pictures, posing right, left, center. You put a cute picture, you've not tagged those brands. Let them know that a sister spends some coins from their brand. That's one thing. Again, broke influencers, if there's one thing I will tell you, it's not about how much what you're wearing. It's about how you style it up. She said it. She can make Primark look like Gucci. You want to be Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang, but you can't afford Gucci? Don't ruin yourself. Hell no. Hell no. The past 2 weeks, the internet went crazy over this other YouTuber's situation about her visa, stuff like that. Personally, I decided I wasn't going to talk about that. It was not my business. I stay minding my business. But yeah, if one thing you could learn from that is, it's all about image, but at the same time, there's one thing. If you've got 70,000 plus subscribers, and you cannot milk money from the brands you're working with, sis, you don't know your value. Know your value, add interest, add tax. Really? Yeah, free clothes, it's an amazing thing. I, for one, I've got like 3,000 plus followers on Instagram. My following is not there yet. I could do, you know, free clothes, free shoes, free whatever in exchange for a post. Yes, I could do that because I'm still growing my feed. But do these free things pay the bill? The answer is no. Brinny Lee, she showed a lot of stuff from companies. Nasty Girl, Pretty Little Things. She showed a lot of free items that have been given to her. Would they pay the bill at the end of the month? The answer is no. So why have you, you know, built your following? You've invested. Do those clothes you see on Instagram, on those girls, do they come free? Do those clothes I put on, do they come free? No, I buy them with my own money. She mentioned that with that brand, some brands are so selfish. You see a brand will come and take pictures. Hell no! You scout for locations. It is freezing cold. You find a photographer. In my own case, hobby is my photographer, but over here in Dubai is the complete opposite of what she said. Dubai is hot. Summer is coming up. I will endure all that heat. Eh? Carry myself. Me. Go under that sun. Punish my husband to take me pictures. Instagram post. Right there, right, left center. A brand comes to me when I've made it to, when I've made it big. A brand comes to me. Dolly, we would give you free clothes in exchange for 5 Instagram posts. No. Hell no. Yes, the answer is no. You've got to know your worth, sis. When I'm telling you, when that girl filmed that video, it was so inspiring. She said, if you guys don't know, the money off YouTube is like this. She mentioned she filmed a video which had 54,000 or 60-something thousand views, and the sister made £68. Hey God, I was like, Jesus Christ. So me now that I film these videos and I don't even get 5,000 views. Oh Lord. I'm not at that point here where I'm making, where YouTube is my income. I have told you guys already, this is not my income. This is a passion. This is something I do strictly for the passion of it as of now. You've got to have several sources of income. You can't depend on YouTube. And one of the worst mistakes that you influencers do is they start blogging or a YouTube channel. They quit their main jobs. Hey, Papa God, oh, God help me. Really? Why are you quitting your main source of income? Why are you quitting your job? I would never. My main job is first, YouTube. Second, I just had to react to that video because she dropped so many. She dropped so much. She mentioned that you see some YouTubers, they have worked hard for their following. They actually influence what people buy. And then they would, a company contacts them to do a review, hair reviews, and they'll charge like £100. Ha! I was like, eh? So when I get to that 100,000, okay, you guys can start knowing that your girl coins are getting in. Yes, that's true. Lots of, and the funniest thing is lots of influencers don't even know what they are supposed to charge. She mentioned that she was thinking of creating like an agency. Yes, sis, yes, go right ahead and create that agency. You're going to, you know, help a lot of influencers. People don't know what to charge. For example, I'm at 3,000 plus followers on Instagram. I've had a couple of brands who contact me. Yes, I'm happy to say that. But for, I don't even know, I wouldn't say I don't know what to charge, because I do a lot of research. And of course, you've always got to negotiate. Listen, your girl is good at negotiating. But lots of people out there don't know their worth. They don't know what to charge to a brand, like a big brand, Elf, Maybelline. Big brands contact them to work with them. I see they start charging £100, £200. Brinley put her hands on her head like, oh my, really, really? Influencers, if you're an aspiring blogger, an aspiring YouTuber, I would say do a lot of research. Just don't just jump into this, you know, and you sell yourself short. Do a lot of research. Definitely watch Brinley's video, because she said she was thinking of doing a part two. I am waiting for part two of that video. I need to catch every little bit of information that girl has got to share with me. Yeah, that's just what I would say. I wanted to film this video. I know there are a lot of small YouTubers like myself who may not have watched that video. I definitely needed to react to that video because the sis, she was dropping bomb after bomb. Thank you guys for watching this video. This is the end of it. I hope you've learned one or two things, especially for aspiring bloggers, YouTubers, small bloggers. Yeah, I hope you've learned one or two things. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.